Noyina is probably the most sophisticated science vessel in the world at the moment. This vessel is essentially like Disneyland for scientists. It is so well equipped.
I'm standing in the centre of the winch room of the Noyina. Fortunately, this is kept below decks to protect all the winches from the harsh environments outside. There are six winches in here. On my left, I've got the deep sea coring winch, which is made of synthetic line, which has several thousands of metres of line on it. To my right, the deep sea towing winch, which is a fibre optic cable that we can send over the side and power equipment such as cameras. The towed body winch over here, which is another powered winch. You can see here the motor on the winch, which drives the shaft of the winch, and then the second motor that runs the worm drive for the spooling gear. We've got our big heavy duty trawl winch here. We've got two of these port and starboard, which can be used in unison. So this is the science deck on the Noyina. This is where the wires come out of the winch room, go through these diversion sheaves here, into another couple here, and straight out the A-frame to deploy a various range of different scientific equipment. As we move further aft, I've got a couple of Gilson tugger winches on port and starboard. They're basically used for transferring loads and dragging different equipment around the deck. We've got our two scientific trawl winches, which are used for the nets to collect samples for the scientists. We've also got our 10-ton XXX crane, which moves on a trolley system fore and aft on the deck and has a 360-degree swivel, which has been a real game changer for us to be able to move equipment around the deck, which means the vessel is very equipped for multi-purpose scientific events on one trip. All the cables from down in the science deck, such as the deep sea towing, the deep sea coring, the towed body, come up at the back of the superstructure through this channeling on the deck head, through diversion sheaves and out the back of the A-frame. So the amount of work being put out there is almost limitless. Whatever scientific equipment the scientists want, we can put it out there. Either side of the ship, we've got our two towing booms. Once again, we can divert our wires and tow things from the stern of the ship as well. From that spot there, our operators can drive all the various different winches and have a good view across the science deck when deploying. Our winches can be either driven by there, locally at the winch, or also by remote control.
When we looked at the range of science we want to support out to the future, we realised there was a couple of different sorts of science where containerised capability would be really useful. Obviously, a lot of science happens off the back deck of the ship. So we've actually got eight positions back there for laboratories and support containers to enable us to put on whatever we need in the future.
This is our area where we keep our science laboratory containers. We've got a side loading crane here. We can pick them up when we're in port and move into several locations. They've all got different services there that they can be plugged into, such as salt water, fresh water, power, and many others.
The containerised setup of the Noyina is a real world first, and it just enables us to be so flexible in how we approach science. So it wouldn't really matter whether we have a group that's focused on the genomics of the Southern Ocean. They can have a specialised high-tech genomics lab all self-contained within one of those containers. Similarly, we can have right next door atmospheric research with the world's best atmospheric lab equipment actually in one of these containers.
Down below this frame here, this is part of our deep sea coring system. This is a bit of a new one for the ship as opposed to the old one. This will all be bolted together, spread out across the science deck, lifted over the stern, and when deployed, that can take a core sample over 20 metres down to thousands of metres below the surface.
The advantages of a moon pool in a research vessel, and for us, is that a lot of our work is in the sea ice. So we would used to have to rely on either making a puddle or a clear area to be able to do a deployment. Now we've got this nice bit of open water with this hole through the hull or through the vessel, so we can put packages in there like our water sampling devices, we can put nets, we can put remote operated vehicles down there.
These ROVs will allow us to go under the ice and sample what's happening below the ice, which is totally fascinating. It's got a whole biological community living on the bottom side of the ice that we know very little about.
Advantage of having instruments on the drop kill is that they've got different positions. They can be placed flush with the hull, but they can also go lower, down to 3 meters under the hull. And so that allows to get past the layer of bubbles, which is a major problem for underwater acoustic instruments. They can't see past the bubbles.
And there's lots of open water patches in the ice, so we'll be able to put the drop keel down, do measurements, pull it back up when we're going through heavy ice, and put it back down when we're in really light stuff again. So that's going to allow us to survey areas that we haven't been able to survey acoustically before.
All the machinery in both engine rooms is all resilient mounted, flexi mounted. The idea behind that is to reduce the vibration and the noise for all the scientific equipment. So the propulsion system, part of the propulsion system is it's based around the scientific equipment on the vessel as well. And that's what makes this vessel pretty special.
Noyena also comes with a forward outboard deployment system. This is an arm that sticks out the front of the ship that you can actually walk on. It's like a whole gangway, which can hold instruments, which measure things in front of the ship, and also lower them down towards the ice. This allows us to measure properties in front of the ship, particularly on the ice, before the ship gets there, before the ship affects it.
Actually bringing learnings from physical sciences and biological sciences and chemical sciences, and this vessel is so well equipped that it's actually going to enable us to be able to take those sort of measurements in parallel so that we'll get a really holistic understanding of how the Southern Ocean ecosystem and the Antarctic continent functions.
There's a mix of experience, youthful enthusiasm, and everyone's here to give this job a red hot crack.